time when I got you.
Remember that time I did that math problem for you?
Yeah.
Yeah, can I just double like
it? Remember
that time we were in the group and I did all the problems?
Yeah. That was last week.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, my color!
Deal! Oh, yeah, the glasses. call Brian because he called everybody by the first name. Y'all did great. Y'all happen to have AirPods for you?
Good. I do.
So long as one of
them
is on.
Only
so I can tell you you're doing such a bad job.
No. It's always trying to tell us we're doing a bad job.
Every Rubbit Network,
we can
just,
I can use mine. It's already calibrated.
Yeah, we don't need both of them. Just in case someone tells
us. Yeah, but I can use mine.
It's just so no one I can make fun of you.
It was 69.18 for us?
Yeah.
Okay. I meant to put that up on the graphic and I missed it.
You want to do the video?
All right. I think what we'll do is, so did Ms. Pope put in, Ben made another video this time for swimming and diving that we're going to play? I'm not trying to go play it before the game. I'm going to play it at halftime. But we have to film the cheerleading performance at halftime.
Can you film it again?
Otherwise, the fans will get upset.
The GHSA and its member schools have made a commitment to promote good sportsmanship by students, athletes, coaches, and spectators at all GHSA
sanctions. I put it in the format, but I'll tell you on the video that it's on there. We're going to show our swimming and diving video.
Intimidating actions directed at the officials or competitors will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the event. Spectators are not allowed to enter the competition area for warm-ups or while the contest is being conducted.
Yeah, we will.
Thank you for your cooperation and the promotion of good sportsmanship at today's
event. So we're going to show a video Ben made for swimming and diving, and I'll tell you when it's off, and just say, you know, that was a video by Ben.
He said, yes, we're going to start with the speaker.
How about this? Something like this. That was a video by senior Ben Starkoslow. We look forward to swimming and diving.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Wallace Gymnasium on the campus.
How about this? Is this good? Are we live? All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Noah Claxton, and I'm joined by Thomas Brown, John Jarakitis, Adam Young, and Jim Clausen in the booth, alongside with Kaylee Johnson on camera. Tonight for the starters, first for the visiting Warriors, it's going to be number 2, Cameron Crisp, number 10, Malachi Harris, number 11, Jalen Pugh, number 12, Niles Washington, and 15, Croy LaDuff. And for the Lovett, it's going to be Jay Joshi, the senior, Christian Anderson, the freshman, Kyle Walters, the sophomore, Zach Minatola, the senior, and I believe Mutombo. And Ryan Mutombo is going to be starting. Number 21, the big man.
Number 11, Jaden Push.
I'm going to use that throughout the game.
Number 12.
And I'm also joined by Aiden Hahn and Layla Hurd. And we're going to have a good matchup. The last game, if you didn't see it, the girls beat the Warriors. Warriors, they shut them down. They didn't even score. They didn't even score but 18 points. and we shut him down to a 51-point game. So we'll get you here underway shortly, and it's going to start in about 2 minutes.
Number 13, Kyle Walters. And number 21, Ryan Matumbo.
So we'll get this underway here shortly. And it's going to be Kip Atlantic Collegiate's ball to start the game. So Pugh inbounds it to LaDuff. Out to Harris. That's number two, Crisp. Out to LaDuff. LaDuff with it. Harris. Drives. Shoots. No good. Gets his rebound, though. And LaDuff. And it's up by Washington, and it's good for three.
Those are the defensive possessions that you really want to limit. Those offensive rebounds by the opposing team are never good for these lines.
Oh. And can't lay it in there, so LaDuff takes it down the court. Pugh with it. Cameron Crisp at the top, out to Harris. Crisp in the corner. Washington, no good. He's one for two from three.
They Joshi try to go back
takes
to
it
back.
Down. Takes it himself. Gives it to Minatola. And tries to reverse and gets fouled on the way down by Cameron Crisp, a senior. Crisp is 6'6", so he's only 3 inches shorter than Matumbo. Man.
Mm-hmm.
So Minatola gets two. First one's good. Second one falls in. It's good. So Pugh gives it to LaDuff. Looks over, directing traffic. Out to Washington. Washington down to Malachi Harris with it, takes it, loses control, and gives it to Cameron Crisp. Washington with it, out to Crisp. And it's no good.
That's grabbed a really
net there.
That's a really good defensive possession from the Lions, picking up everybody that was switched, either by passes or screens, and getting a big stop. That leads to a bucket.
And Ryan Matumbo lays it in. So he's 1 for 3 from field goal range. Pugh. Crisp at the top. Everybody moving around. Washington with it. Out to Pugh. Harris takes it. And it's going to be a, I'm not sure what that was, but it's going to be Lovett ball. Anderson takes it. Kyle Walters gives it to Minatola, and just short. So LaDuff takes it down court. And it's going to be a charge.
Good job by Walters to get the offensive foul called on him right there. Get the ball back in the offensive hands of the Lions.
So Joshi's going to take it with 5:23 left in the quarter. Out to Minnetola, down to Walters. Minnetola, Joshi at the top. Takes a shot and it's good. Nice layup. So Jalen Pugh takes it. Malachi Harris, Corey LaDuff, Jalen Pugh back with it. Out to Wash, out to Harris, and it's no good. Bad pass.
Well, ever since that three-pointer from Niles Washington, the first possession of the game, they've gone stone cold. They haven't scored in about 3.5 minutes.
Yeah, Lions on a 6-for-0 run in about 2 minutes. And Mutombo lays it in. So Washington with it, gives it back to Jalen Pugh. Losing ball control, and it's out of bounds, and it's going. Going Lovett way. That should definitely go.
Yeah.
I mean, that should definitely go Lovett's way, but it's going Washington, or Warriors way. So Chris, Jalen Pugh takes it. Malachi Harris. Close to the baseline. Crisp. Out to LaDuff. Guarded closely by Walters. Takes a shot. Washington, no good. In and out. Tries to save it. No good. So Minnetola takes it. Okay. Minnetola shot, no good. Harris with the ball. Takes a shot, no good off the left corner. Or the right corner, sorry. So Joshi takes it. 8-for-0 run for the Lions in the past 3-4 minutes. Walters with a three. It's good. That'll make it 11-0. So Croy LaDuff's going to take it down the court. Lions haven't scored since Niles Washington came up from the corner, or from the top.
This three-pointer was now about 5 minutes ago in this first period, so they're going to need a bucket quick.
So Cameron Chris with it. Jalen Pugh takes it, and it's no good. Did you see the foul there?
No.
A lot of stuff being called, but. And checking in is Dominic Crisp, the brother. He touched out his brother, Cameron Crisp. So Joshi takes it. Anderson with a three. Oh, in and out. Walters gets the rebound, takes another one, and that one's good. He's 1-for-2.
That's a great rebound from Kyle Walters to get Anderson's missed three and then to find him back for three and for him to knock it down. Second chance opportunities are huge.
So that's the second three from Niles Washington from three, and that's their Only two scores. Oh, too hard off the glass, and that's going to be Warriors' ball. Croy directing traffic. Harris with it. Niles Washington back to Harris. Jalen Pugh tries to set a screen, no good. Guarded closely by Joshi. Jalen Pugh with it, guarded closely by Minnetola. Niles Washington. Only points of the game so far for the Warriors. And it's stolen by Minutola.
That's an unbelievable defensive possession from the Lions.
And the fast break was stopped there.
The Warriors couldn't get anything offensively. The Lions, whoever was on them, was all over the offensive, whoever had the ball. And they convert a turnover.
So 50 ticks left in the game, in the quarter. And Croy LaDuff takes it down the court.
And already just under, now we just up dip under 45 seconds left in this first period. Lions up 10.
Yeah, only points from LaDuff, or Washington.
Have been 2 3-pointers.
And checking in is going to be number 22, William Overly, and number 1, Colin Goldberg. And stick around, ladies and gentlemen, for the halftime, as we're going to have an exciting performance for your varsity cheerleaders and a good video from Ben Thurkaus-Schlund for swim. You won't want to miss it. So shot no good from Dominic Crisp. Sends it out to Baxter Barber. Barber takes it, guarded by Anderson. Takes it, and Anderson's going to be charged with a foul. Barber going to inbound. And Dominic Crisp can't get it.
Got to get something fast for the Lions.
Oh, nice pass. Colin Goldberg sends it to Mutombo. And almost. Anderson gets the shot. Oh, that would have been a great
buzzer beater. That would have been an unbelievable shot by the freshman prodigy.
That was a fantastic job of just getting that shot off into anywhere near the basket.
Yeah, just like a shooting hope.
So if you're just joining us, I'm Noah Claxton. I'm joined by Thomas Brown. And we have a good one in store. And the 2020 state champion, Al Coy, is on a mission to defend his title with an 18-1 record in his senior season. Al has been a rock in our program every year since his freshman season, says Coach Billy Maldonado. His unorthodox style makes for an entertaining match every time he steps up to the mat. He also has 11 varsity letters at Lovett. It has been a pleasure to coach him. Congratulations, Al. You're the Campus Star Athlete of the Week. Yeah, the Coy family, just a good group of athletes. Parker, Al, and any fan.
You are not kidding.
And, yeah, Al Coy won state last year.
Yep.
Sydney Lamberson won state this year for cross country. Boys won cross country state. So, a lot of state titles this year.
Yeah.
Hopefully, Lovett Swim and Dive can get some. Hopefully, Lovett Swim and Dive can get some championships. And if you're just joining us, once again, I'm Noah Claxton. That's Thomas Brown. And we've got live coverage from the riverbank. It's a nice day. It was a really nice day out here.
It was a sunny, sunny blue sky day.
So on the floor for the Lions, number 13, Walters, number 1, Goldberg, number 22, Overly, number 2, Anderson, and number 21, Mutombo. As it was a nice pass to Roverly, as they call him, and it's a nice assist from Colin Goldberg. So Pugh with it. Washington, Crisp, sends into the middle, no good. Taken outside. Harris with it. Washington. Out to Barber. Washington again. Crisp tries to take it. And it's no good. Tries to get a foul. No good. No call. Up to the top. Walters out to Anderson. Nice pass from Anderson to Goldberg. Out to Walters. Chose to take, no go. Takes it, and it's a dunk by the big man. Big Christian slam.
Christian Anderson has had some flashy passes so far this quarter. He had one to end the first period on that final possession, and he just had one there.
And he steps on the line. That's Barber on the line. But checking back in is Croy LaDuff, as Washington still only has the points for his team. Mutombo has to tie his shoe. You know how big that shoe is? Size 22.
No, it's not.
It's what he told me.
Is it actually?
That's what Mutombo told me. I asked him. I was like, how big is your shoe? He goes, 22. And I'm like, wow. I don't have any classes with him, but it would be an honor to just be anywhere with him. He's awesome. He's a nice guy off the court and on the court. So Goldberg takes it. Mutombo with it. Anderson.
Oh, tried to get the lob. And
pretty good lob, though.
Mutombo's slow to get up on that last play. Maybe just recovering as now he speeds down the court.
Washington again, and that's the ninth point for him and the ninth point for the Warriors.
Yeah, he's got all their points, and it's just from some three threes.
And one. So Mutombo using those big arms to his advantage. He gets pulled down on the way, but that doesn't stop him as he's going to get one shot, possibly make it a three-point play. So checking in is F.A. Biljan and Jay Joshi. And Overly being really aggressive.
Yeah,
he was the only lion down there other than Mutombo. As they switch out the ball with new COVID rules.
COVID regulations.
Limited fan attendance and limited attendance in general. As Barber's going to take it down the court. Barber getting a little bit of separation out to Cameron Crisp. Niles Washington. Interesting move. That's going to go Warriors ball. Goldberg almost steals it, and where's the foul, Mr. F?
Where's
it's going to be on Goldberg for a hold, apparently. That's an interesting call.
Apparently.
That was not a hold, but it's going to be called. So Goldberg tips it on a fast break. And one. So Goldberg with a chance to make it a three-point play. And that's a nice play by the little guy.
That's one heck of a play right there.
He's a star player, been Campus Door Athlete of the Week. He had a few accolades as a junior, as a freshman. He's just amazing with it. And Overly gets called for the push. So Croy LaDuff takes it down the court for the Warriors. They're down by 15. Speaking of 15, number 15 takes it. Number 21, Mutombo gets the rebound. And tried a fast pass there from Goldberg, but no good. So Harris at the top, right under the logo. Then Croy LaDuff at the top of the Lovett logo.
Manitola getting ready to come back in.
Barber in the corner, no good. And that's the first point from Cameron Crisp, and that's the first point from a person other than Niles Washington. We've called his name three times with three threes. So Goldberg with it, out to Overly. Overly takes a shot. And Barber takes it down the court, sends it out to Harris. And that's no good. He gets his own rebound, sends it to Croy LaDuff, and that's no good. Gets his own rebound, sends it out to Niles Washington, and that's finally good.
So a lot of opportunities there, and Coach Harner is not happy, and the Lions will call timeout. And he's fired up as the Lions get into the team huddle.
So are you True Blue? Lovett's True Blue Annual Fund raises close to $3 million on an annual basis to support the school's most immediate needs. We rely on the support of our entire Lubbock community to meet our fundraising goals and provide every Lubbock student with the highest education possible. Thank you for being true blue. So Lions up by 10. Some nice action here. I was going to say some nice action in the bullpen, but, you know, we're not the softball field or the baseball field. Don't know where the bullpens would be.
Nope.
But some nice action here from the Lions as number 5, Minnetola, is on the court. Number 21, Mutombo. Number 2, Anderson. Number 4, Joshi. And number 35, Biljan on the court. 24-14, your score with 4 minutes and 20 seconds left to play. Joshi takes it down the court for the Lions. And Mutombo, the big man, takes one, and it's a layup.
And Coach Harner draws up the perfect play coming out of halftime. An easy bucket for Ryan Mutombo.
So Harris. Whoa, that's a travel.
Yeah, that was.
There's another travel, and that one's called. So there's another travel, and Chris comes out, and I didn't see who came in for him. Oh, his brother came in. So one Chris comes out, the other goes in, and Joshi comes in and takes it down the court for the Lions. So Anderson takes it, and it's going to be Barber with the foul. Be sure to stick around at halftime for an exciting performance from your varsity cheerleaders. Minnetola from 3, no good. And a video for a hype video for Swim and Dive brought to you by Ben Thurker Schlum. Malachi Harris with it. Takes it. That's no good. Tries to get his own rebound. No good against the big man Mutombo. Gives it to Joshi, who takes it down the court. F.A. Biljan with the 3, and it's good. Biljan, nice with it. That ball curved a lot. From our point of view, looked like it was going to be off the back of the rim, but goes right in. And no good. Bad pass.
A lot of miscommunication there on offense for the Warriors causes another turnover.
So Joshi takes it. With Biljan outside. Ooh!
Oh,
that would have been a nice play right there.
The lob.
Croy takes it. And the foul is going to be on Biljan, but it's a good contested shot. And the student section gradually gets bigger and bigger as we go on. With 2:40 left to play, as Croy LaDuff is going to take two.
First shot, good.
Thank you. So Croy LaDuff with his first point, good. Second one, no good. Biljan gets the rebound. Joshi sends it to Biljan. Oh, and again they try
right
the lob a little bit too high.
Yeah, they've been trying to
but
work
the
in that lob.
Still not expecting it. So ball swap. And Croy LaDuff takes it. Christian Anderson gets around the pick. Niles Washington with it, guarded by Minnetola. Dominic Crisp, I should say. Jalen Pugh back out to Crisp. Takes a shot from Washington, no good. Mutombo takes it. Joshi coming down the court. Tries a little move. Sends it to Walters. Minnetola. Joshi. Call shot, no good. There's a shot, and it's good. So up by 16 here with 1:40 left to play in the half. As Croy LaDuff takes it down the court.
That was really good defense by Christian Anderson, holding his own with the mismatch.
And Anderson takes the easy layup, and it's good. Pugh takes it, takes a shot, and it's blocked.
Oh.
And a foul is called.
Man.
I wish you guys could see Coach Harner. Coach Harner just flipped his mask up to his face, to his eyes, in disbelief because he couldn't see it. And I don't think the ref could see it either. But it gives Pugh the opportunity to go to the line and shoot two. First free throw is good.
And there's just 104 left in this second period to end off the first half. Lions 33. And Kip Warriors 16, but can they make it 17? Yes, they can.
Second shot, good. So down by 16 still. Joshi sends it to Minatola, up to Walters, out to Joshi. 54 seconds left. Anderson with it. Anderson takes it. And a nice shot from Walters, and I'm not sure who the foul was on. I think it was on Dominic Crisp. Yep, it was. So Anderson's going to inbound. Walters with a shot. It's no good, but Mutombo gets the rebound, and it's good.
That's a great putback by Ryan Mutombo. So big, so strong.
35 seconds left to play. Ooh. Pugh outside. And it's going to go Lovett ball. So in just a minute, we'll see the varsity cheerleaders as they are not in the gym, as they're getting ready for the show. With Joshi taking it down the court out to Walters. Minatola with it. Mutombo takes it. Easy layup, and it's good. Extends the lead to 30, or 20, sorry.
If you get a stop here, that'd be a perfect end of the half. And the basket,
and basket
is good. A
Buster
Beater.
Baxter Barber with the, oh my God, the
totally,
buzzer beater.
Totally
behind half court. And no matter what team you're on, you have to say that's a great shot.
Wow.
And we're going to show you a replay of that one. That's a great shot from Baxter Barber. Wow. So he cuts the lead down to 17, and here are the varsity cheerleaders.
Yes, ma'am. That's what they're doing right now. Okay.
And now, to the floor, the Winter Varsity Cheerleading Squad!
Did you see that shot?
I
Thank you.
falling, and he shot it from like all the way over.
Switched it too.
Exactly. It wasn't like a pace where like the guy like crossed up Sebastian.
Everybody thought he was squishing.
Yeah. I was there though. I was there.
And that video was brought to you by one of the swim team state members, Ben Thurkosh-Lund. Looking forward to see what this state swim team can do as they take on 1A through 3A schools on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday for prelims and finals. So we'll see what they can do this week, and looking forward to state. And we'll be back with quarter number three momentarily. And we're back for quarter number three action as the Lions are up. Great final play from Baxton Barber. The Warriors' last game was a win versus Sterile, 69-53. And for your Lions, it was a win versus Washington, 79-63. As the Warriors are going to get the ball. So Pugh inbounds. Sends it to Chris. Back to Pugh. Back to Chris. Washington. LaDuff. Out to Harris. Chris. Pugh. And puts it in the goal. Walters gives it to Joshi. Drives down the court for your Euro Lions. On the floor of the starting five. And 6-6, Cameron Crisp, sends it out of there. I don't think Lovett has accounted for that height differential of only 3 to 5-ish inches. So Anderson takes it, and that's money. 3-3-3 all over the place. So up by 18, Pugh takes it, sends it to Cameron Crisp. Malachi Harris coming outside. Pugh and Chris. Then Anderson takes it. He's going to take it all the way. And that ball is going Lovett way. Last touch by Niles Washington.
That was a nice defensive play by Christian Anderson. He got behind his guy on a move and then just poked it free from behind.
Walters wide open. Takes a shot and it's no good. Rebounded. Pugh takes it down the court. Drives it and is blocked. So Washington takes it with 6:40 left to play here in the third quarter. That's a travel, but no call. And down by only 16 now. Walters sends it to Anderson. Joshi sends it out to Minatola. A lot of pushing going on down low, but Mutombo makes it work, and it's good for two. Pushes the lead to 18.
That was a perfect pass by Jay Joshi. Mutombo showed where he wanted it with his hands, and Joshi dropped it on a dime. An easy layup for Mutombo.
So Chris sends it to Harris, then out to LaDuff, and that's a push. He's doing it again. No call. Keeps pushing off. Mutombo with the rebound. He takes it himself. He's the point guard here. And Harris steals it. At number 12, Niles Washington. He had the first 9 points of the game. Gets another three right there. And he's going to get one. And it's good. So down by 14 here. And Warriors playing press defense, gets it across, takes it himself, and it's good. Nice attack from Kyle Walters. Freshman Walters sophomore. I remember when we were a freshman, he was a freshman standout.
Just last
year. Similar to Christian Anderson, as Niles Washington takes it, no good. Rebound by Chris. And he has to, and that's a double dribble.
And he knew it right away.
He knew it as soon as he heard that whistle that he double dribbled. He thought he could get away with it for a second, but Walters inbounds to Minatola, back to Walters. Joshi takes it across court. 21, Mutombo takes it, no good. Good shot though. Washington tries to take it all the way, sends it outside to Malachi Harris. He takes a shot from mid-range, and it's no good. And they're making their own guys fall. And that's Niles Washington with Jalen Pugh. Cameron Crisp takes a shot, and it's no good. Kyle Walters with the rebound, getting the bunnies. Bunny hops. Joshi takes it. Malachi Harris takes it down court. Sends it back out to LaDuff. Cameron Crisp with it. Jalen Pugh trying to make something happen here. Niles Washington close to a travel, and that is going to be a travel. So down by 16, the Warriors have had a few travels uncalled, double dribble recently. And Walters is going to inbound it, gives it to Joshi. Joshi with it. Minatola outside, and that's in. No doubt about
bang,
it.
Bang,
that's
bang,
bang, bang, bang. Three-point play. Get those every day. Crisp's going to set a screen. And Jalen Pugh gets the shot. So they're down by 17 here with 3:08 left to play in the third. And Mutombo takes a shot. And this is quickly getting away from Kip Atlantic Collegiate. So LaDuff takes it. Takes a shot, no good. Gets his own rebound. Then Joshi gets the rebound and gives it to Mutombo. And Walters could have taken a shot.
Oh,
and it's good. Man. That gets the crowd electrified. We like those. LaDuff takes it. Walters gets the rebound. Joshi. And momentum stops as that ball's thrown out of bounds. And Barber, the one who hit the amazing buzzer beater, comes in.
Ryan looked like a freight train.
Just he plowed through. He wasn't going to stop. You better get out of the way of him.
Cruising down the lane and flushing it down.
He quickly electrified that crowd. So Barber takes it. And Mutombo blocks it. Number one, Colin Goldberg. He takes it. And that was a good read by Goldberg. And let's hope Mutombo's okay. In the corner was Harris, and he shoots it out to LaDuff. Dominic Crisp tries to fake out Lovett. And Coach Mathis calls a timeout.
Just
so they're
going to
check on Mutombo there. And here is the dunk from Ryan Mutombo, the freight train just coming in. Let's hope he's okay. He took a hard fall.
Yeah, he took a
guy
mean
tripped
fall.
Him up.
Tripped.
The Lovett Parent Association is the organization dedicated to promoting volunteer interest among parents in support of the school and engaging in activities promoting the enrichment of all students, faculty, and staff. There are many opportunities, small and large, for you to make a positive impact. Visit the Lovett website to become involved in the Lovett Parent Association today. So Mutombo's going to sit a few out. And Baxter Barber is going to take it. Washington takes a quick shot.
Try to get the and one call again like he did just a couple minutes ago.
Yeah, they tried. They got William Overly for blocking there.
Yep.
So that'll send Niles Washington to the line for three. So first one from Washington is good. Jalen Pugh is going to come in after the shot. Second shot from Washington is good. Jalen Pugh comes in for Dominic Crisp. So Niles Washington, his final shot. And it's good. 3 for 3 goes Washington as the energy has gone way down ever since that Mutombo block.
Yeah.
Momentum shifted. Lions still up by a lot. Goldberg takes it out to Woverly and tries to get away with a travel, does not, and it's going to go Warriors ball with 1:12 left to play in the third. Harris out to LaDuff. It's in and back out and then
in,
back
out
in.
And back in.
So 59 ticks left on the clock tonight, or today, for the third quarter. Woverly outside. Anderson, and a nice assist from William Woverly.
That's a tough shot from Anderson. Great control.
So about 40 seconds left. And Baxter, Barber with it. LaDuff outside, back to Barber. And Belgian get called for a foul. That may have been one of the softest fouls I've ever seen.
Yeah.
So it's going to be LaDuff to inbound. He's going to look for some open targets. Send it to Braxton Barber. He takes it. Jalen Pugh. And it's no good. 15 seconds. Oh,
man, that was
close. Foul call.
He got the perfect pick and roll from F.A. Bilgin and drove right to the net and got the foul call.
Yeah, nice deception there from Bilgin, getting the defenders off their feet and making it think that they were going to be going to the right side when they went to the left and drove. So Colin Goldberg with the shot with 5.9 ticks left. And the first basket, good. So Goldberg gets one more. 18-point game. And that shot, no good.
Almost
tried to mimic his teammate Barber there. Couldn't do it. And that's the end of the third quarter. So the Lions are up. And we have a good game going here, Thomas. The Lionbackers welcome you to an exciting season of winter sports for Lovett Athletics. Your support as both a fan and member of the Lovett Lionbackers is essential to the success of our athletic programs. With your help, we can continue Lovett's proud tradition of pursuing excellence on the fields, courses, gyms, courts, tracks, and pools. Please consider joining the Lovett Lionbackers organization today.
The girls like had a thing where like they had the clock running because they were up by like 50. They won by 51. Yeah. The Lovett girls, right.
So we have 8 minutes remaining in this one. Warriors versus Lions. Who's going to fight it out to the end? Lions up by 18. And Lions are going to get the ball to start. As on the court is 13 Walters, 1 Goldberg, 35 Biljan, 22 Woverly, and 2 Christian Anderson. So Goldberg takes it. Got screen. Posts some guy up. And a foul call. Really late foul call there. They were about to go down the court when he called that foul. But it's going to be on LaDuff. First shot is good from Biljan. Second shot good from Biljan. LaDuff trying to get this offense on a fast pace. Pugh trying to get some separation. Good communication from the Lovett defense. LaDuff tries to take it in. And it's going to be at the baseline. I wonder who that call is going to be on. That's going to be on Goldberg. That's his second foul of the game. Barber to inbound. LaDuff with it. Woverly. And it's going to be a backcourt violation. Good attempt by Woverly to steal the ball. And then it goes backcourt. So Walters inbounds to Goldberg with just under 7:15 left to play here. Woverly with a shot. Nice pass from Goldberg. And they're going to go to the line for two. So William Overly going to the line for two with 7:08 left to play. Lions up by 20. And that's good.
Bank it in.
And Thomas, if you multiplied the score of the girls Warriors by two, you'd get the boys Warriors. So times two, the power.
Yep.
But also got to play faster. Second shot, no good. Biljan gets the rebound. Walters with it. Overly takes it. And a nice shot. Kind of laid there for a second, trying to deceive us.
Yeah.
And Baxter Barber is going to take it.
That was a tough shot. There was a lot of contact there.
Yes, it was.
And it powers through for two.
Jalen Pugh outside fakes a shot. Washington takes it. And that's good. So 20-point game still with Goldberg with it. Sends it out to Biljan. Takes a shot. Wide right. Mutombo getting ready to come back in. Something funky there. I don't know what.
There was a lot of moving and not a lot of dribbling on that.
But look at Ryan laying down in front of the scorer's table. It's kind of funny.
Just relaxing.
He's as long as the whole table. 5:53 left to play. Up top, Biljan. Nice hands by Goldberg, number one receiver.
Yeah, that's
got named all region this year, I think. Ooh. And a nice shot to the face from Kyle Walters. I don't think he meant to do it, but.
Nope.
So Mutombo comes in for Walters. Joshi comes in for Biljan. Jalen Pugh's going to inbound to Croy LaDuff. .536 left to play here, fourth quarter on the Riverbank. Lions down, up by 18, and the ball stolen by Goldberg.
Throw
fast
it down.
Break. And he lays it in. It's nice. against GAC, he attempted a dunk. Everybody in the stands was amazed, but just lays it in right there.
Yeah,
and
the
that
crowd,
moves the score back up to
the crowd wanted just an attempt for a dunk.
And Anderson with a nice little reach in. Gets it outside to Washington. Takes a shot. Two. No good. No good. And that should be a foul. And it's blocked because ball don't lie. Dominic Crisp almost took a shot there. Jalen Pugh going to try to set a screen for Malachi Harris. Jalen Pugh back with it, the junior. Takes a shot. And that's no good. 21. Mariah Mutombo takes it. Gives it to Joshi. Goldberg inside Mutombo. That should be a foul, but no call. And Coach Mathis calling out plays. And a timeout called by Manuel Mathis. So the road to state starts here with swim and dive as we got Auburn commit, Avery Bergeron leading the way for the girls team, and a lot of seniors heavy on the boys team as it's going to be a great, great year for Lovett.
Yes,
as GHSA rules have changed where, or the protocol changed, as they can't have a big meet like they normally do. So girls are going to be on one day, boys are going to be on another day. And then they'll have a good time. And then it'll only be 1A through 3A this year, but normally it's 1A through 5A, so it lowers our chance of winning. But this year, with limited competition, Lovett State team has a chance to take it home and win it. Last year we got 7th in state, and it's a good swim team is a great way to exercise your body. So 4:14 left to play. In the fourth quarter, your Lions up by 20. We've been on a scoring drought. And camera two over there, hello everybody. If you're just now joining, I'm Noah Claxton. I'm joined by Thomas Brown. As we have four minutes and some change left in the game. And the ball tipped out, but stayed in bounds. Woverly guarding. And he puts it back up. And Dominic Crisp comes over top, and Joshi takes it. He looked like a receiver out there. He's played receiver before. Anderson takes a shot. That's no good. But Joshi gets the ball. Anderson takes another shot. And that's, oh, so close. And Overly gets called for the punch. So Overly with three fouls tonight. And Overly comes out. Minatola comes in. After the season, Minatola will be headed out to up to the hill to play on some Lovett baseball. Great player out in right field he plays. Dominic Crisp with it. Tries some sorcery. Malachi Harris with it. Tries to make a good move. Hands up, and that shot's good. So Joshi takes it down the court. Anderson in the corner. I couldn't even see him, but it's going to be a travel.
Yeah, neither could I. I thought he just threw it away.
Yeah, I couldn't see him, but I knew he was over there when I saw only four other Lions. So one Chris comes in for the other, and I am certain for a fact that the Chris brothers play in shifts. They play the same position, and Dominic comes in, Cameron goes out. Cameron goes in, Dominic goes out. Pugh, Crisp. Cameron Crisp, that is. Pugh with it. Tries to take it inside. Cameron Crisp. And he's going to get called with a charge. And that's a charge.
That's a charge.
So Dominic Crisp coming back in for his brother, Cameron Crisp. And indeed, they do play in shifts.
Ooh. A lot of trouble.
And Mutombo loses it. And nicely tipped in. LaCroix, LaDuff, sorry. I keep calling him LaCroix. LaDuff. Nice fake. Harris with it, takes it. Shot over and under the legs of Mutombo. They're so big, it's not that hard. Jay Joshi sends it out to Anderson. Takes a shot and it's good.
Man
for three.
Alive. That's such a pretty shot from Christian Anderson.
So Dominic Chris with it. And Zach Minatola doesn't even know that he did it, but he did it. He hit him upside the head, and he's looking like, what'd I do? And Baxter Barber comes in alongside Marcus Martin. This is the first time we've seen him tonight. So Martin gets his first touch of the ball. Chris tries to post up Mutombo. Doesn't get
That's
to do it.
That's not going to work out very well.
And that's a foul on Minatola as Davis Caldwell and Alex Walters are coming in. No relation to Kyle Walters for the first time tonight. And Cameron Foster Martez and Stevie Bracey are also coming in alongside Sebastian Schroeder. So a new five on the court for the Lions.
A whole new five with just 137 left.
Ooh. So 137.
A whole new lineup with 97 ticks.
Yep, 97 ticks. And that one's good. And Mutombo, Walters, Kyle Walters, that is, Minatola, Woverly, and Christian Anderson all come out. New five on the court for your Lions. Cameron Foster Martinez, number 32. Number 12, Sebastian Schroeder. Number 3, Davis Caldwell. Number 31, Alex Walters. And number 34, Stevie Bracey. So those are the five on the court. As that's a foul on Cameron Foster Martinez as he just got in the game. 9 seconds ago.
9 seconds ago.
So Pugh with it. No tall guys on the court anymore. LaDuff takes it. Shot. No good. It's flat. And right on his own player. So Lions up by 24. Stevie Bracey with it. Number 19 on the football field. And it's a jump ball. I think that's a jump ball. Nope, it's going to be a foul on Cameron Martinez. So that was an interesting foul. And it gives Kip Atlanta Collegiate a bonus. So any foul from now on, it's going to be 1-1 now. And then 8 fouls will make it a 2-shot bonus.
Right now.
32, Cameron Foster Martinez. 34, Stevie Bracey. Davis Caldwell with it. Walters wide open, and he can shoot. Just didn't go in that time. 32, Stevie Bracey takes it, and that's a travel. That's a travel. Mr. Referee having some fun. Oh, that was funny.
That
37
funny.
Ticks left.
That was funny.
Lions up by 24. Martin out to Crisp. Stolen by Cam. Cam on a fast break. And it's going to be stolen. And Cam with some nice hustle.
Yeah, Cam.
23.2 seconds left in the game.
Tried to save it.
So 22 seconds and counting on the clock. Jalen Pugh takes it. And it's good. Sebastian Schroeder takes it. He's going to just stand there, gives it to Walters. Stands there with Cameron Foster Martez, and that's going to end it. So it's going to be a 22-point game. Your Livet Lions win it 67-45. For Braden, for Thomas Brown, John Jerakias, Jim Clausen, Adam Young, Aiden Hahn, Layla Hurd, and Kaylee Stargill, I'm Noah Claxton. Final score from the Wallace Gym, 67-45. We thank you, everybody.
Good night.